Good morning. Linnaeus once said that the first step to wisdom is to know the things themselves. So gone, the still life in the middle, it has 63 species that have gone extinct, so they're all sort of candidates to be brought back. In order to paint these species, I have to become intimately familiar with each one. It takes a year, roughly, if you divide it out, to make each one of these pictures. Each one begins with a database, really, and there's lots of research and lots of drawings. I read the original scientific description, and often that really is more diagnostic than descriptive. After getting to know all these things, I end up with a finished composition where the eye moves comfortably around the plane and the colors are balanced. Each painting explores a theme in biodiversity, such as endangerment, black and gray market trade, or new discovery. Each species is painted at life size so that everything is correct in relative scale, whether it's increased or decreased in size. All the materials I use are archivally very stable so that if the pictures themselves are lucky, they might get to survive for a century or more. And with Gone, that was particularly important to me because I wanted to be able to keep this human-motivated loss in people's minds across time. Most of the species were drawn from specimens at natural history museums and herbaria around the world. And firsthand observation really is important so that you're not too influenced by someone else's photograph or painting. But really, it's the story of each species that makes me want to preserve the images of the things themselves. Each is so unique, so idiosyncratic. So I'll begin with a few of the things that are there. I included the great auk as an egg, since I couldn't fit it in the picture. But every single egg is unique, like a snowflake is unique. It never repeats. The speckles are always different. There are just so many amazing things in the world, like this gastric brooding frog. I mean, what on earth caused that to evolve, that the eggs would be swallowed and the babies would emerge from the throat? Then there's this sort of apocryphal story about the Stephen Island Wren. In 1894, Stephen Leal was a lighthouse keeper. He happened to have a cat, and the cat brought this cute little tailless bird to him, and he thought, that's probably a new species. So like a good citizen scientist, he sent it to the British Museum. It was a new species, but unfortunately, in the meantime, the cat, Tibbles, caught almost every single one of the birds on the island. You can just picture the cat's glee because they couldn't really fly very well. This is the Xerxes blue butterfly, one of the first insects we know of to go extinct. It disappeared in the early 40s from the area where San Francisco meets the sea, and the first invertebrate conservation group was named after the Xerxes blue, the Xerxes Society. This is a group of bivalves that live in the watersheds of the eastern United States. They're very highly diversified, lots of endemics, and they've gone extinct in droves. There have been a lot of things that cause that disruption. They've been affected by siltation and dams and water pollution. But one of the odder things that happened is that these shells were used for buttons on prairie dresses by the thousands. They all had little buttons down the front. The thylacine is probably the most maligned and misunderstood species of this whole group of extinct biota. They were thought to be horrible sheep killers, and the government of Tasmania was still offering a bounty after the creature was already gone. Each of these stories illustrates sort of the unintended consequences of our actions. What we have left is remorse and remains, shells and bones and feathers and tissue and the certain knowledge of man's hubris. De-extinction maybe could be a new tool. A new corrective practice to patch up some of the holes in these natural systems that we rely on, and particularly the large holes left by keystone species. I think we're going to need all the tools at our disposal in order to effect some real repair to the systems that support all life on Earth. And it's in our best interest to keep the planetary systems working as much for ourselves as for some of these iconic species. Thank you very much.